special event taking place in Egypt, and it's organized by the Indian Embassy in Egypt. It's India by the Nile, and for the first consecutive year, the Egyptians all are excited about that event. Every year, the Indian Embassy surprises us with a variety of events. And this year's event, actually, it includes a lot of things. It includes a Bollywood show, and actually the Bollywood troupe, they entered Egypt from the moment they stepped at the airport. They started dancing and performing with beautiful, colorful outfits and the beautiful music. Also, there'll be food. Actually, it has started. It started on the 23rd of this month, and it will continue till May. And food, exhibitions, art, all of the various cultural aspects. And to shed more light on that exquisite event, we have with us His Excellency the Ambassador of India to Egypt, His Excellency Sanjay Bhattacharyya, as well as his wife, Mrs. Ranu Bhattacharyya. Welcome with us.
Delighted to be here.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for joining us. And let's start first with the festival, because you know how much the Egyptians has you know, connection with the Indian festivities, and definitely, you know, with these series of festivities, there is a lot of you know, traction. Looking at the social media, there has been trends even on the festivities. So if you can give us a little bit of, you know, background about what happened so far.
Well, we are into the fourth day of the festival. We started earlier this week. We started with an event that Ranu and I were very fond of, called the Women of Substance, in which we recognized the remarkable contribution of 12 Egyptian women to this great civilization, to its economy, its society. It was followed up by a food festival, and what we tried to do was to showcase the fusion of modern techniques with traditional Indian cuisine, and it's being done at the Four Seasons Hotel with the right through the week. And then we got into the Bollywood mood with the Bollywood musical. It's absolutely spectacular, yes. And it's magical, and it's a love story that comes out, and I welcome you all to come and watch it. But it's got many other themes, social themes, environmental. There was a beautiful film on the Nile, done by an Indian environmentalist, which was premiered yesterday at the Hanagar. And we are very excited about its prospects in terms of bringing about greater awareness on the environmental issues. But there's many more, classical as well as contemporary.
Interesting.
Well, Your Excellency, I'd like to ask you first about the choice of the Bollywood troupe, because actually it's quite a popular Bollywood troupe. So the choice of it.
You know, the Bollywood troupe is coordinated by our partners' teamwork. They revise the theme of the musical every year. So it's an entirely new production in that sense. What it does is it takes contemporary film songs and then it works out the choreography. And some of the choreography is given a very contemporary flavor, and some of it reflects the classical dances as well as the folk dances of India. So through the Bollywood musical, you actually get to see a microcosm of the great diversity in India.
Yes, and since we spoke about several segments of this festival, let's start with your interest, the woman's part, and if you can elaborate a little bit about that and what happened and what was the woman's role in that.
Well, we wanted to recognize some distinguished Egyptian women here, because the experience of Egyptian women and Indian women seem to mirror very similar experiences. And we wish to honor their valor, their zeal, their determination to succeed. And we formed a small jury of previous women who have been awarded this honor. And along with me, we selected some lovely, lovely ladies who are completely inspirational. And to hear them talk, to hear their life stories, was a revelation in itself. We had Amal Fikri, who who supports the Light and Hope Foundation, which works with the visually impaired girls, and they play an orchestra, and that orchestra has actually been to India. So, and every woman on that list was truly a role model for people to follow.
Yes, this is very interesting. So that was one of the recognized women. What about the other categories? I understood that there is the economy, there is a lot of aspects also tied to this, sort of honoring or recognizing those women in their role in the community.
Absolutely. So again, going back to the women, we had some members of parliament who have played a prominent role recently. We had, given our interest in crafts, we had two ladies who are responsible, who've been responsible for curating some traditional handicrafts of Egypt. They spoke about how their experience has been that these are crafts that need to be really patronized even by modern day Egyptians, and they should not die out, because it's a full circle between somebody wearing a piece of fashion and the craftsman actually crafting it. As part of that as well, we have a small platform that we are trying to promote about creating a platform between Egyptian craftspeople and Indian craftspeople, and it's my sincere hope that that takes off as well.
Well, Mrs. Ranu, actually talking about fashion, I'd like to ask you about your dress. Is this the traditional Indian dress, and would the dresses, the traditional dress, vary from one province to another in India?
Yes, what I'm wearing is a sari, and the sari has been there for centuries. Some people think it's a costume. It's not a costume. It is very much part of our wardrobe, just like a pair of trousers or a shirt. It's part of my mother's wardrobe, my grandmother's wardrobe, as well as my daughter's wardrobe. And so this is it's an unstitched garment, and that we drape in various styles. So even the sari can be draped in different styles across India. So a person from the north would wear the sari differently from the person from the south. And the weaves are also very different. The saris are, again, part of our handloom. So each sari, there are very rarely two saris that are exactly the same. So it's like wearing a piece of your heritage. It's like wearing a piece of art on you every time you wear, you drape a sari.
Representing the identity to
Absolutely,
Indian culture, definitely. And going back to the festival, because there is a lot of objectives behind this festival, and it's bringing in this bonding between the two countries, creating awareness for the Egyptians and your presence here, and this continuous effort by the embassy trying to tie in with the Egyptians is really doing a great job. If you can also shed some light about how those Egyptians, how are they responding to those festivities?
We obviously have multiple objectives for each of the years that we've done the festival. For this year, we had a couple of key objectives. One of them was to connect with the youth. And so we brought along India's best known rock band called the Indian Ocean. They had opened at the Gumuria, which was a wonderful performance. And then the next day, they performed for the first time at a university to young people at the Ayn Shams University. As you know, we have a deeper connect with the Ayn Shams University because we are establishing the first Indian chair at the university. And Indian Ocean, which plays marvelous music, had a rapturous welcome by the young students over there.
We saw that on Twitter. It was massive on Twitter. It was one of the trending hashtags.
It was absolutely huge. They were all on their feet and dancing away. That's just the emotion that we wish to create. We also had another objective, which was to connect with the social awareness issues. One of them was the environmental issues, and therefore the film on the Nile, and we had a very good discussion yesterday about that. The other one that we are doing is to connect our experiences on how we address the issue of street children. This is something that is very common to both India and Egypt. In that segment, we have a very successful example of a young boy who had run away from home with less than $1 in his pocket and who was a street child. And today he's grown up to be a world-renowned photographer. So we will be having his photo exhibition, and we'll also have a discussion panel on sharing experiences on this work. The third thing that we did was actually to link up business with culture. As Ranu was mentioning, it's a sense of pride that you must have about your heritage, your cultural being, but at the same time you have to constantly innovate your crafts so that it is adaptable and received well in the market. And I think in that way you give a new life to this beautiful culture that we both possess. So we are now connecting business to the crafts, and there's a very exciting project that's coming up that we are looking forward to having Indian and Egyptian designers and craftsmen come together.
It's a fusion of, very interesting.
Well, Your Excellency, I'd like also to ask you about the other various cultural activities taking place here in Egypt, because actually the Moulana Azad Cultural Center is quite active, whether dealing with the Egyptian Association for Cartoons, always the cartoon exhibitions, portraits, drawings. Also, you've held several film festivals, including the latest one was about the films of Shah Rukh Khan, I think. Wasn't it true?
Well, I think the Indian experience is very diverse. Our cultural experiences are so huge that there is a lot to offer. Mm-hmm. And we try and bring in different aspects of it to our Egyptian friends. Of course, the Culture Center does its own work in terms of the spread of Indian languages, Hindi and Urdu, as well as yoga and Indian dance, including Bollywood dance, which is now getting very popular. There is a great attraction of Bollywood films, and we'd like to see more collaborative activities in that. I am always tapped by the fan following of some of our greatest iconic film stars, whether it be Bachchan or Shah Rukh, and I'm actually very excited about their level of interest.
Yes, and I don't know if you noticed or not, but there is a number of channels having series of Indian movies, and people are really following that. And even if you watch some certain cafes would be having those Indian movies on play. I don't know if you're following this, attraction from the Arab nation towards the Bollywood art.
I find this very active on the social media in particular. The kind of fan clubs that have been set up and the high level of Twitter activity about Indian movies is very, very attractive.
Yes.
But I find this it's wider, and I think the reason for this is somewhat the likeness in the social mores and culture of our two societies, both in India and Egypt. The societies are very structured in similar fashion. I think we place great emphasis on family, on relationships, and a lot of that is reflected in Bollywood.
Yes.
And so along with the social issues, you also have what really affects us all, love and romance and dreams. That's what Bollywood does so beautifully. We will continue to do that. Last year when we had the Cairo Film Festival, there was a lifetime award that was given to Farah Khan, one of our very well-known directors and choreographers. And on that occasion, we had a gathering and we tried to work out how we can have more collaborative exercises of Indian films being shot in Egypt, Egyptian films being shot in India, and maybe also get to have casts that work together.
Well, Mrs. Ranu, I'd like to ask you, how long have you been in Egypt and how do you find Egypt so far?
I feel like I'm at home here. When I meet people on the streets, the way they greet me as an old friend. I've made several friends here in the time that I've been here. So I feel very much at home over here. And the familiarity with Indian culture is actually quite phenomenal. It's also very reassuring to know that these bonds that have that we've read about in the past are as relevant today amongst the young generation, and that we are able to make homes in each other's hearts. Because we live in such a global world that that's what matters at the end. When people are connected to people, I think we can go ahead and solve a lot of things for the future. So we do a little bit of feeling at home and feeling very welcomed by the people over here. And I hope when Egyptian people go to India, they are able to experience the same level of warmth.
Yes. We grew up with the time of Egypt, with political turmoil. We continue to have those festivities and the festivals, which was really great, despite this fact, we continued. I wanted to know from you more about, the cooperation level and what do you have in terms of plans that can have maybe agreements between both countries on the cultural issues, because you mentioned this is one of the social aspects, because there are a lot of commonalities, there's a lot of issues that were solved by India that maybe Egypt be leveraging, and leveraging the existing resolutions that was kept in place and the ideas and plans. So what about that?
Well, a festival of this magnitude obviously requires a great deal of preparation, and we've been working on this for close to a year. And I must thank the administration, the various ministries and cultural organizations in Egypt for their tremendous support. As also to the people of Egypt, because at the end of the day, we don't want it to be an Indian festival. We want it to be an Egyptian festival. And I think I'm very, very grateful to the people of Egypt for having accepted this festival. I think what you said is very true, because culture forms a basic foundation on which everything else develops. And that forms the bond on which we then proceed, not just on cultural cooperation and collaboration, but also an understanding at the political level, also engagement at the economic level. You would have noticed that through the last few years, Indian investments have continued to grow in Egypt. And today, we are looking at even more so. So culture forms that bonding, which is much more than just culture.
Well, speaking more about that, we'll be moving now for a very short break and returning back with more, so stay with us.
Welcome back, and you're watching Nile Cruise on Nile TV International, and we're continuing our interview with His Excellency, the Ambassador of India to Egypt, His Excellency Sanjay Bhattacharyya, and his wife Ranu Bhattacharyya. Welcome back, and I'd like to ask you about the Bollywood story, love story. Would you tell us a bit about it? Because you're saying that actually it's the first time to be screened here or performed here.
Well, Bollywood has been a part of India by the Nile right from the beginning.
Yes.
And what it does is it brings a huge musical performance. It also brings along with it a Bollywood dance workshop, mm-hmm. which is kind of a build-up. And as you mentioned, that the very day that the Bollywood team arrives in Cairo, there is a flash mob which is attended by a very wide number of people. Back home in India, Bollywood is something that a lot of people build their dreams on. I mean, mm-hmm. they're long romantic love stories, and people love the costumes, the fashion, mm-hmm. the color, and we try and bring some of that over here.
Mm-hmm. Well, Your Excellency, what about the films? The choice of the films chosen, you've mentioned the successful figure of a child. What other films will be screened?
I think there are a number of Indian films that are very popular over here.
Mm-hmm.
There's scarcely a day when I step out of the office and I'm not reminded of Amitabh Bachchan, for instance, mm-hmm. or Shah Rukh. And I think what we try and do in the Bollywood musical is try and have the music from very many different of them. But I think Bollywood films itself is gathering more traction in Egyptian theater today. Recently we had one of Shah Rukh's new movies being featured in the films over here, and I hope that there will be many more.
Yes. There is part also in the festival that's going to be about the well-being experience at the India, and this includes also yoga experts and this beautiful experience. So if you can shed some light on that too.
Yes, in fact, this afternoon we start off our well-being part of the festival with a seminar which is going to look at alternative medicine and yoga. We are going to be featuring, strangely, the two prominent alternative medicine practices in India are Ayurveda, which is Indian in origin, and the other one is called Yunani, but actually it is Arabic in origin because we have a very strong connection. So they will be discussing some aspects of that in the well-being session this afternoon. Tomorrow we have a major presentation at the Children's Civilization Theatre where we will have yoga. Over the years, I have found that yoga has become immensely popular in Egypt, and it's seen as by many as a solution to many of the health issues. But I think we should look at yoga as a holistic experience to achieve harmony, both within oneself and with the external environment outside.
Yeah.
Mrs. Ranu, I'd like to ask you about the food, because actually part of the festival will be also a food festival.
Yes.
So would you tell us about the most characteristic features of the Indian food?
Well, the food festival has been very exciting to plan because the chef who is here, he's a celebrity chef who's come from India, and what he was doing was he was giving us a little bit of an idea of fine dining. So the food that he is presenting has a mix of flavors, and it's plated very beautifully so that it's a little bit of a bridge between Indian flavors but a slightly more novel presentation. So the food both tastes beautiful and looks beautiful. It's been fascinating working with Chef Vikram Udagiri because he's very young, he's full of ideas, and these flavors have been very popular at the Four Seasons Hotel. And I think if you go to take part in the food festival, what's going to surprise you is that people think they know a little bit about Indian food, but the way he presents it and the flavors he's brought in are probably going to be surprising for the Egyptian palate in a very pleasant way. So it's food that you're familiar with but presented beautifully.
Well, I'd like to ask you also about the choice of choosing dancers, Donna Ganguly.
Yes. Yeah. Donna Ganguly is going to perform Odissi. Odissi is a dance form, very old dance form from Orissa. Mm-hmm. And she comes with this large dance troupe that who are going to perform at our closing ceremony at Gomoria, and then thereafter they're going to travel out of Cairo. Odissi is one of the classical dance forms of India, and while Bollywood is very popular, most people don't realize that most of the choreographers of Bollywood are actually trained classical dancers. So your body has to be built for in the rigors of classical dancing and the technical aspects. And it is a very difficult discipline to be able to move with Bollywood numbers. So to be able to see this very graceful lyrical style is something that I'm looking forward to, and I hope it's going to be exciting for Egyptian people as well.
Yes, we're sure of that. Make in India is an economic seminar aiming to engage with the investor community and continue to assist them by providing updates on government policies and initiatives aimed at increasing the ease of doing business between Egypt and India. If you can tell us a little bit about this initiative.
Yeah, you know, this is the first time we are bringing the economic content into the India by the Nile Festival. And the reason is that we have a fairly large economic engagement with Egypt, which we would like to develop and make it bigger. We also realized that this is a two-way traffic. So if you look at trade, it is very big, $5 billion of trade, but a lot of it is Indian exports to Egypt. We want more of Egyptian exports to India. If you look at investments, we have about 50 Indian companies who have investments in Egypt with about $3 billion worth of investments here. But we'd like to have more Egyptian investments in India as well. The reason for this is simple, because today we are in a very globally integrated economy, and we must have opportunities where capital and technology flow to those areas where greater opportunities are available. And today India is the best destination for investments. Last year, India received the highest amount of FDI anywhere in the world. We had about 700 new foreign investments start off in India. And we want our friends in Egypt, with whom we've been partners for so many decades, to be part of this growth story, because this is a shared win-win solution.
Yes, I would like to thank you very much for joining us, Ambassador Sanjay and Ms. Ranu. It has been a great pleasure to have you with us. With all the information and insights, I wish you all the best and within the festival and even beyond the initiatives of cooperation between Egypt and India. Thank you very much for coming.
Thank you very much. It's been a pleasure being here, and I wish you a great viewing with India by the Nile.
Thank you. It's been a great pleasure.
Let's move now to the upcoming story and the Hungarian festival. I'll be returning back with more sustainable.